I have seen now what the work of a forensic auditor has done. There were payments made to Vitaly Petrov in 2019. There were payments made in 2020, and there were payments made in 2021. So anyone saying that he only paid recently in 2021, that is an outright false statement. And that will not stand up 1 second under any kind of scrutiny, because I can provide the wire transfer evidence and show exactly, I can show you exactly the transfers and what was made and on those dates. And it was in 2019, 2020, and 2021.
How were these payments done? Because the claim is that EJ paid late.
He did pay late, but you know, who's accusing him of paying late? Is it PATAFA or the PSC? You should see some of these dates. There's a board resolution from the PSC that says we'll grant him this amount of money. The grant is paid from PSC to PATAFA months later. PATAFA sits on the money for 4 months, 3 months, 5 months, and then suddenly sends it to EJ. I mean, who was late? I mean, everybody's late and on the whole thing. Now, EJ, we admit he's late. Now, here's the interesting thing. And this, you know, this system is so messed up. If this was a corporation, everybody involved would be fired and we would have to start over. You have a Filipino athlete living in Italy, Gretchen. Now, what's the currency in Italy? It's the euro. EJ needs euros to live. He needs euros to pay the bills. His coach is a Ukrainian national living in Italy. He wants to be paid in euros. He doesn't want pesos. It's not a convertible an openly convertible currency. He wants euros. So what does everybody do? They pay all of EJ's expenses in Manila in pesos into different bank accounts. They've paid into his bank account. They paid into his mother's bank account. Now, you have people like, you know, PATAFA saying, we don't understand why the money's coming out of his mother's bank account. Well, you're the ones that paid it into his mother's bank account. So that's the explanation. You paid it in. Now, EJ is stuck. Through most of the season, he is completely swamped. He's traveling. He's working. He's not. And I can tell you, this is a great man and a great young man and a great, amazing athlete. But you know what he's better than being an athlete? He's a better human being. He's a good person. But he's not an accountant, and he's not any good with numbers. And I can tell you that now, having spent several days trying to help him. He is not good at the numbers and at managing the accounting side of things. So through the season, money comes in, but it's very complicated, Gretchen, because it doesn't say this is for Vitaly Petrov. It's just a lump sum of multiple payments, which include rent, housing, food, it's all lumped together. And he has to figure out, of the 300,000 pesos, how much goes to rent, how much goes to that. We don't make anything easy on him. So he gets that number. And what does he do? He pays the rent and everything first. And he's a bit slow paying Vitaly, because Vitaly treats him like a son. And Vitaly says, you know, it's okay, just get it to me later and all that. Now, when it comes to the month of November, why is November so special? Because November is the only month of the year where he's on light training. So November is when he gets all caught up. So if you go and look in 2020, last year, he comes to me in November and he says, Sir Jim, I have to pay Vitaly. I've got all these pesos and he only wants euros. I called my bank. My bank said, we only do transfers in dollars and you have to handle the euros separately. He said, could you help me? I will pay you the pesos and you pay Vitaly in euros. What did I say? My wife and I said, of course we'll help you. So I wired Vitaly 21,000 euros and EJ paid me 21,000 euros in pesos. What's the big deal? I mean, what I look at in the fault in this is simple, Gretchen. Why do we make our athletes not get the money they need, not pay it up front, not pay it in the right currency, not pay it into the right country? We just dump it into a Manila bank account and he has to manage the rest of it. And so that's the Dubai account. The Dubai account is my account and I paid part of Italy, but it wasn't my money. EJ paid me for that. So he took the PSC money, he sent it to me. I converted it into euros and I paid Italy. Done.